Moin Moin, welcome to Streaming Every Day. This channel is all about media streaming and my experiences as a media engineer. We will be learning lots of stuff related to media streaming here, so please feel free to comment if you find something wrong or you know some other ways of doing these things that we will be doing here. It would definitely help all of us, as I'm also still learning. So with that, we start the learning right away. In this video, we will learn how to create your own DASH-based web media player. For those of you who don't know what DASH is, don't worry. I will put a link in the description for DASH for a general context, although DASH stands for Dynamic Adaptive Streaming over HTTP. It's an adaptive bitrate streaming technique that enables high-quality streaming of media. But first, let's see how a DASH reference player looks like. So we go to the Google and we search DASH reference player, and the first result probably will take you to the DASH reference client. Now here we have the option of stream, wherein you insert your stream, and the load option which will start the video. And in the bottom we have a graph area. There you can see the video buffer level and bitrate, but you can also choose other parameters. You can see that probably here on the right side under the video category. The same you can choose for audio, and you will see the audio graph then there in the bottom. So let's test one stream. We select the on-demand profile and select the load option, and there you go. I will mute the video so that it does not overlap with my voice. And here what's important is we have this bitrate list option, which is what adaptive streaming is all about. So the quality can be changed according to the network conditions. And yeah, so that's what we want to build. So for that, we go to the star option here on the top right, or we go to Google and we search DASHJS GitHub. Simple. Now, once you find the repository, it will look something like this. And yeah, so if you have time, you can read it. Definitely, it will help you. But we are interested in this code block under when it's all done, and we copy this. Now we paste it into the IDE of our choice. I'm using VS Code. So I will create a HTML file called index. You can choose the name and I will paste it. Now if you know HTML, then it's probably very easy for you. But if you don't worry. Just look for the source option. We are interested in the source option and the URL. So we need this dash all main.js file. So how do we get this? Again, we have to go to Google and we look for CDN.js. Now again, you can read about it, but for this purpose, you just have to go to CDN.js, look for dash.js, and once you find it, just copy the first link that appears, and that's what we need. That's our dash all main.js file. So we copy it and paste it in the source. Now, next thing is the URL. That is the manifest file that we need. Now, what is a manifest file? I can make a separate video about it, but for now it's a media representation description. That is a document that contains metadata. Now, we can search it on Google for free MPD files. And yeah, there are a lot of options. You can make your own MPD file as well, but for now we just look for free MPD files online, and I will go to this OTTverse website. It's quite popular. And yeah, I will just grab a video on demand link. Yeah, this one. And I will paste it in my URL. Simple. Now, one last thing that we need is a live server to run this HTML page. So I will go to the extensions and I will look for live server app or extension. Yeah. So I have it already installed in my system. So what you have to do is just install it and enable it, and you are all set to launch your own web player. So all we need to do now is go to the index.html file and right click and open with live server. That's it. There is your video player. You can also type in the local host and the port name. But yeah, this is how you build your own Dash based web player. Now I also have a code where I can change the resolution, I mean this size of the video on this HTML page. So I will quickly grab it and show you that this can also be changed and customized according to your needs. And yeah, I like whatever project you want to use it in, you can change it and you can add styling to it with CSS. I'm just going to show you how. I'm not going to show you the code exactly, but I will show you that okay, it can be done. So I'll just paste it here so that I don't have to create a new file, and I will grab the MPD file that we recently used because I think the other one is not working right now. And yeah, I will delete this. And so here we go. Now with this code, now we will see the video is bigger on the HTML page. So yeah, that's how it's done. If you have any questions, please write in the comments. I will be happy to answer all the questions. And yeah, see you in the next one.